Welcome back guys, my name is Ehsan and you are watching Creative Design. Today I am going to teach you how to create a professional and beautiful website absolutely for free. And all this will be done using the XAMPP server that we have created in one of my previous videos. If you didn't see that, then I will recommend you to watch that video first. You can watch that video by directly clicking on the card link above. For creating this website, we are using the best and free resources like free Elementor Page Builder plugin and free Astra theme. Although we are using free resources, it has all the basic and essential features that a professional website must have. And you don't need any technical and programming knowledge to create this website. It's just simple drag and drop. Let me show you that if you want any changes, then you will see on every page edit with Elementor link. By clicking on that link, you will see the Elementor Page Builder page, from where you can edit everything. For example, if you want to change the content of that section, you can directly click on this pencil icon and you can change the text if you want. And if you want to change the text of that button, you can simply change it from here. And if you want to add the link, you can add any kind of link like this link, you can add here, okay? And if you want to change the content of this section, you can do it so. Before we start creating this website and before I show you step by step how to create this website, let me show you the demo website. So normally what happens is that you have to watch the complete website 2 hours long tutorial and wait till the end of the video to see the final result. But I don't do that. I prefer to show the final result right at the beginning so you guys can get a better idea about the website you are going to create and can see all the different features and the design, and you guys can make the decision right at the beginning whether you need to watch the complete tutorial or not. So right now I am going to show you the same website and also going to show you the design and the features that you can create if you follow this tutorial step by step. So this is our homepage and this is our header section. On the left side you will see the logo and on the right side you will see our menu section, and next to this section you will see our contact information, and this is our call to action section with a very beautiful button, and this is our banner section, and this is our about us section where we are showing our about us information with a CTA section, and in this section we are showing that what kind of services we are providing, like residential cleaning services, commercial cleaning services and customized services with a very beautiful button. And in this section we are showing some more details about our services, and in this section we are showing that in which areas we are providing our services, and this is again our call to action section. And this is our testimonial section where we will show our clients' reviews. And finally, this is our social handles section where we will integrate our social media pages. And this is our about us page. And this is our page header with a very beautiful title. And in this section, we will show our owner details. And in this section, we will show that why we are best. And this is our CTA section. And in this section we will show our pricing, and this is our team section, and this is our residential page, and this is the page header with the title. And in this section we are showing our services related to residential customers, and in this section we are showing some more information, and this is again our CTA section with a very beautiful button. And in this section we are showing our gallery. And this is our commercial page, and this is our page header with the title. And in this section we are showing our services related to our commercial clients, and in this section we are showing some more information, and this is our CTA section, and this is again our gallery section. And in this section we are showing our partners details using a very beautiful carousel. And finally, this is our contact us page and a title within a page header, and this is our contact us form which we will create using WP form, and this is our a little bit more information, and this is again a call to action section but with a different style. Alright guys, so that was a very short demo of the website that you are going to create in this video. Now guys, I think that you have a better idea about the website that you are going to create in this video. So if you like this video and if you want to create the same website. Let me remind you again, we are using only free resources to create this website. So if you like this demo website and if you want to create this website for free, make sure to watch this complete tutorial. You will get all the files, all the images I will use to create this entire website, and I am giving everything for free. There is a link below in the video description. If you click on that link, you can download that entire file absolutely for free. Before we proceed further, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any future notifications. Throughout the video, if you have any doubts, any comments, any suggestions for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. If you find this video helpful, give a thumbs up to this video, and I would highly appreciate if you guys could share this video on your Facebook and Twitter. I would really appreciate that. Alright guys, with that being said, let's start creating this website. So first of all, we will set the color palette and the typography. So click on global option, and from here you will see typography option. Click on this and now click on base typography, and from here you will set the entire text of your body and select the Open Sans font family. The font size will be 16px and the font weight will be normal 400, and the text transformation will be default, and the length height will be 1.8. So now go back, and from here you will set the heading sizes. So for this we will select Open font family, and the font variation will be medium 500 and bold 700, and the font will be 500, and the text transformation will be capitalized. Next, we have to set the heading 1 font size 52px, and now we will set the heading 2 font size. Font size will be 38px and font weight will be 700 bold, and text transformation will be inherit. And for heading 3, the font size will be 30 and the font weight will be medium 500 and the line height will be 1.27. Heading 4, font size will be 26 for, and the heading 5 will be 22, and the heading size of the heading 6 will be 20. So now we will move to the color palette, and from here we will set the text color. The code will be 2A2F4F. The theme color will be F23D49. Now we will set the link color, and the code will be F23D49. Now set the link hover color, and it's again F23D49. And now we will set the all headings color, and the code will be 2A2F47. And now we will set the background color, and the code will be EFFF5F7. So now go back, and from here we will set the container size of our site, and the width will be 1200px and the layout will be box layout. Click on publish. Now we will set the buttons text color, and the text color will be #FFFFFF. And now set the background color, and the color code will be F23D49. Now we will set the hover color of the button, and the background color will be E23849. Now we will set the typography of the button, and the font size will be 15px and text transformation will be uppercase. Line height will be 1.8 and the letter spacing will be 1. Now we will set the padding of the button. From left we will set 18, from right also it will be 18, and from right and left it will be 35px. Click on publish. Now we will move on to the next part, and it will be to set the header of our website. So this is our header. The logo is on the left side, and this is our menu section, and right side we have to show the contact us information. So first of all we will create pages, and then we will add these pages into the
our nav menu section. So for this we will create our first page. So our first page will be home page. Click on publish, and now our home page has been created. Now we will create our next page with the name of about us. So click on add menu, about us, publish, publish. And next page will be our residential page. Publish and click on publish again. And our fourth page will be our commercial page. Publish. And the fifth page will be contact us page. Publish. So now we have created all of our pages. So reload this and you will see that our 5 pages has been created. So now we will set the permalink, and for this you have to click on permalinks and click on post name and click on save changes. And now our permalinks has been created. Now for creating the menu, we will go into the parents, and under parents you have to click on menu, and from here you have to create new menu, main menu. Click on create menu, and from here you can add all pages into your new menu section. Click on add new, and now set the position of your pages or menus and click on save menu. And now we will go into the front end to check that our pages has been added or not, and yes, our pages has been added. So now we will set our logo. For this we will go into the customize option and click on header, set identity, and click on select logo and select the logo. Click skip cropping, and now our logo has been coming, but the title is also showing next to our logo, but we don't want this title. So uncheck, and now site title has been removed. So now we have to add the contact information next to the menu. So by default the last item in menu is by default set as none. Okay, so how to add the contact us information next to menu? For this you have to go to the dashboard, and from here you have to click on widget, and from here you have to add the widget into the header widget area. And now copy this piece of code into the text widget and click save. And now we will see that the contact us information is coming or not. So click on visit site. So it's not coming. So for this we have to come and click on last item in menu and set is as widget option, and now it is showing. So now if you see that the menu position of our navigation bar is not right, because the about is coming on first position and the home menu is coming on the fourth position. So to fix this issue we have to go to the dashboard and click on menu, and from here we just have to click on this primary menu and click on save menu, and now reload the page. So now you see that our menu position or menu issue is been fixed. And now we will set our footer, and I will show you that this is our footer that we are going to create. So for this we will go into the footer, click on footer bar, and from here we will select the middle layout. Okay, and from here we will select this text option and we will enter the text. Okay, copyright text. And now we will give the background color the background color will be our white, and the content color will be black, text color will be black, and link color will be black, and the hover color will be, the code of the hover color will be E04838, and then simply click on, and then simply click on publish, and now reload the page, and now you will see that our footer has been created. So now we will set homepage as our front page. So currently we are seeing the post and the sidebar. So for this we go to the dashboard, and from here under setting option you have to click on reading, and now you have to select static page as a home page. Okay, so select your home page as a front page, click on save changes, and now reload the page. So you are seeing that the sidebar is only appearing. So to remove this, you have to go to the dashboard again, and from here you have to click on pages and click on edit menu of home page, and now on the right hand side you will see the sidebar section. Click on no sidebar and click on update, and now reload the page, and now your sidebar is also been removed. So now you will start creating the body content of our home page. So this is our first section. Now we will click on edit with Elementor for adding the content on our home page. So from here we will select a section, and now we will take the element of heading. Okay, now we will set the heading 5, and now we will copy the text and paste this text into the heading element. Now we will add the button on the right column. Now the button styling is not applying, so to apply this styling we will copy the color, and this is, and the code is in my file. So come into the styling tab and select background color, and now add the code, and now we will give the border radius 6px, and now we will apply the text shadow, and we will apply the animation on hover float, and from here you will apply the box shadow. The color code will be DA3641, and the horizontal value will be 6, vertical value will be 6, and the blur value will be 20, and the spread value will be 5, and position will be outline, and I click on update, and now hover it, and now the effect is applying. So we will add the text, and after that we will make our button center align. So you have to click center. Now the button is set as center align. So now if we click on the section, so from we have to select the width to be box left, and the width will be 1000, and the vertical alignment will be middle, and now go into the style tab, and you have to select the background color to be white, and now you have to go into the advanced tab, and from here you have to apply the padding 50px from the top and 50px from the bottom. Click on update, and now our one section has been completed, and now we will move on to the second section, and we will take the section again, and the width of this section will be 1300px, and now we will go into the styling tab, and from here we will set the image, select an image and insert it, and now we will apply the position top center, and repeat no repeat, and size will be cover And now we will apply the background overlay to be black, and opacity will be 0.5. And now we will go into the advanced tab, and from here we will apply the padding top 160 and from bottom will be 162. And now we will duplicate the column, and the width of the first column will be 60 and then the second column will be 40, and the vertical element will be middle. And now we will move into the styling tab and set the background color to be white, and in the advanced tab we will set the padding to be 60px. And now we will take the heading element, and now we will take the text to be heading 1 element and take the text from the side and paste it over here. And now we will apply the color of the text F23D40F7. So now we will apply the bold . Now we will create our next section. Now we will take the section of 70-30 and the content width will be full width. And now we will go into the style tab and then into the advanced tab, set margin 0 and padding also 0. And from the left column, we will go into the styling tab and set the color to be white. And now we will move into the advanced tab and set the padding 65px. And now we go into the second section, and by going into the style tab we will apply the color code F23D40F7. So now we add the heading element and then add the text element. Now we will take the text from the side . Paste it over here. Now we have to apply the styling on our heading. So for this we will copy the styling of the upper section heading and paste it into the heading, and on the right side we will take the heading element again and we will set the text colors and make it central line, and text color will be set to white. And now we will add the button, and we will copy the button from the upper section and paste it over here, and we just change the background color to white and text color . We'll change the text color. Okay, and now we will add the phone number over here. And now we will set the icon. So click on the button again, and in the content tab you will see this icon option, and from here you can select the phone icon. And size will be small, and the icon position will be before, and icon spacing will be 20. And now we will go into the style tab, and from here we will set the typography, The font size will be set to 20px. And now we will make the content to vertically center align. So for this, we will click on the column, and from here we will set the vertical line to be middle. And now our text is center aligned now. So now we will move to our next section, and the next section will be letters work. So for here, so from here we will take the main section, and we will go into the styling section and set the background type to be gradient. So we will set the primary color F2 F7 FB. So this is our primary color, and now we will set the secondary color FFF or white color, and location will be 100, tap will be linear, and the angle will be 180. Now we will go into the advanced option. From here we will set the padding 80 from the top and 80 from the bottom. And now we will add the heading element in this section. And make the text center align. And now we will take the inner section. Now we will take the inner section of 3 columns. And now we will take the image box element. And now we will set the picture. So here's the image. We will set this image. And now we take the text. So we just only need the heading. We don't need the description. So now we will go into the styling tab and set the spacing to 21 and width will be 30% or 100%, and vertical element will be at set to top and the spacing will be 0. And now our first column has been completely added. Now we will duplicate it and we will remove the extra column. And from here we will just change the images and enter the text. So from here we will select the image. And select the next image. And now take the text from the side. Paste it over here. And now we will give the margin top to this section by going into the advanced tab 30px. And now we will take the text element and now we will make the text center align by going into the style tab, and we will give the margin from the top 40px and margin from right side will be 240 and bottom will be 40px and from the left 240px. Okay, and the padding will be 0. Now we will add the button. So copy that button from the upper section and paste it. Now we will change the text of this button. Click on update. And now we will move to our next section. And we need 2 columns. Click on the main section and come into this layout tab. and select the box layout, and the width will be 1000px. And now we will go into the styling tab and we will select the image. Position will be center, and the attachment will be fixed. Repeat will be no repeat, and size will be cover. And now we will give the background overlay. Color will be 00 and opacity will be 0.017. And now we will go into the advanced section, and from here we will give the padding 100px from the top and 100px from the bottom. And now we will see that what we have. We have these two section, white and the text on the right hand side. So first of all, we will click on the column and change the width of the left column to 52px, and the second column will be 48, and change the alignment to vertically aligned middle, and also the next column vertical aligned middle. And now again come on the first column and come into the styling tab and change the background color to be white, and go into the advanced tab, and from here we will set the padding to be 50px. Now we will give the border radius to be 5px, and we will set the box shadow and now we will color will be by default, and this is the perfect color that we want. And the blur will be 50 and spread will be 0 and position will be outline. And now we will take the icon list element for the content. And now we will take the content from the site. So first of all, we will make one list. And we will add the tick icon or check icon. Click on insert. Now we will duplicate or go into the style tab first of all. And from here we will set the color of the icon F23D49. Okay. And we will set the text color to be F23D49F7. Okay, now we will set the space between 16, and now we can duplicate it easily. Now we will add the content from the other side, copy the content and add it over here. Click on update, and now we will add the content of the right column. Take the heading element, and under this we will take the text element. Now copy the text more. Now we will apply the styling. We take the text, paste it over here, and we have to take the paragraph text, copy it and paste it over here, and change the color by from styling tab. Now we have to give the padding go. So for this you have to go into the advanced padding, and we will give the padding left from 60px. And now our this section is completed. Now we will move to our next section, the service area section. So we will take the section and the content will be 1300px, and now we will add the heading element and we'll make it center align, and under this we will add the text element and also make it center align. And now we will go into the main section and now change the background section F2 F7 FB. Okay, now we will go into the advanced tab and give the padding 100px from the top and 100px from the bottom. And now we will add the inner section. Before adding the inner section, we will add the content. Okay, now we can add our inner section. And the inner section will be of 4 column. The inner section will set to full width and the vertical alignment will be middle. And now we will go into the advanced tab. We will set the margin to 20px from the top, and now we will come into the column and we will add the styling and give the background color to be white, and we will come into the advanced tab and we will give the margin be 15px and padding will be 13px. And now we will add the image box element. Okay, so now we will set this element. So first of all we will take the image, and this is our image, and we will set the size of this image to be thumbnail size. And now we will add our heading, and then under this we will add our text. Okay, now the title will be heading 4, and now we'll go into the styling tab. The spacing will be 30px, width will be 25. After coming into content section, we will set the alignment to the left and the vertical alignment will be top and the spacing will be 10. And now we will give the color F23D49. Okay, this is our title color. And now we will go into the advanced tab. We will set the margin to 0 and padding 0, and our one section is completed. And now we will simply duplicate this section. We need 4 sections and remove the extra sections. And now we can easily add the images and the content. So now we have to add the shadow. So click on column and click on the styling tab and click on border. And now we will give the border to 12px and we will simply apply the border box shadow. And now we will apply this styling on every section. So right click on the column and simply paste the styling on the other columns. So we will just simply reduce the opacity of the box shadow. So we can again apply the styling on all columns. So now it is perfect. So our next section is ready. So now we will move to our CTA section. So for this we will take again a new section, and the width will be box layout. And now we will set the background color, and the code will be hash F23D49EF. Sorry, D49F7. So now we will add the heading element. Sorry, first of all, we will go into the style tab. We will go into the advanced tab. Now we will set the padding from top 30px and from the bottom 30px. And now we will add two columns, simply duplicate it. And the left column size will be 70, and the width of the right column will be 30. And now we will take the heading element, and the heading will be heading 3. So now we will take the text on the side, and the text color will be white. And now we will apply the motion effect by going into the advanced tab, and the entrance animation will be fed in left. Okay, now we will go into the right column and add our button. So for button, we will copy button from the upper section, copy it and paste it over here. Now we will change the background color to white. Change the text color. Now we will take the text of the button and paste it over here. And now our this section is approximately completed. And now we will come into the advanced tab, and we will set the padding 25px. And now come to the button column and also give the padding 25px. And now this section is completed. Now we will go into the next section, and this is our reuse section. And now we will take the section again, and now we will set the content width to be boxed. And now we'll come into the styling tab and set the gradient color, and the primary color will be F2F7FB EFB, and secondary color will be our white color. Now we'll come into the advanced tab, and padding from the top will be 100px. And now we will take the heading element, we will make it center align, and below this we will take one inner section. So we have to break our section into four columns. So we will set the width of the left column to 15px, 15%, and the right column will be 35, and again set to 15%, and the last column will be set to 35%. Okay, and on the first column we have to set the image and set to be full width. Sorry, we will set it to thumbnail size. And on the right column we will add the reviews. Okay, we'll add the rating element, and under this we will add our heading element. For this we will take the image box element, and we don't need the image element, so we will simply remove this and set the position to left. And the heading title will be h6. And now we need the image. We will set the image from our image library. Select this image and insert it. And now copy the text on the side and add the text. And now take the paragraph text. Now we have added the text. And now come again on the image, because our image is a little big. Now come into the styling tab. So from here we will set the width to 80 and the border radius we will set 100. Now we will change the star rating color F2 3D 49 F7, and this is our reviews color. And now we will change the review size to 12px and the spacing will be 10px. Now we will give the spacing to 5px. Copy this image and paste it into the next column. Copy the star rating and paste it into the next column. From here we will set the margin to 40px. And now we will come into the layout tab. We will set the column gap to be wider. Now we will duplicate this section completely. And now we can change the content easily. Now we will move to our review section, and this is our review section. For this we will take the section again. The content width will be 500 and the color will be white. And now come into the advanced tab and set the padding 50px from the top and 100px from the bottom. Now we will add the heading. And now the heading size will be 4. And now text. And now copy the text. Now we will take one more element, and that element will be social icon element. And shape will be circular. Now we will come into the styling tab, and now we have to change the color skin. So from here we will select the custom. Primary color will be F23D492B. Okay. So this is our primary color. Now we will set the secondary color F23D49F7. And now we will set the size to 15. Padding will be 1, spacing will be 15, and the row gap will be 0. That's it. And now we will set the hover color F23D49, and the secondary color will be our white. Now we will check it that it is applied or not. So it is applied. Click on update. Now we will check that our home page is complete or not. So reload the page, and yes, this is our first section, second, third, fourth, fifth section, and sixth section. Now we will create our next page, and that will be our about us page. As you can see that the sidebar is coming on the right hand side. So for removing this sidebar, we need to click on this edit page. So click on this edit. Now you will see this page. So you have to click on edit with Elementor. After this you will see a gear icon. Click on this gear icon and now select the page layout to elements, Elementor full width, and then click on update. After that refresh the page, and then you can see that the sidebar has been removed. And now your body section is black now. So now you can easily add the content. Okay. So now first of all we will create this header section, page header section. So for this click on plus icon and take a section. And then go into styling tab and select the color and add the background color. And now go into advanced tab, and from here you have to set the padding from top 40 pixels and then 80 pixels from bottom. And now we have to add the heading element, so select heading element. This heading element will be h1, and now we have to copy the text and paste it over here. And now we have to change the color, and now as you can see the text is not bold, so to make it bold click on typography and change the weight to bold. And now we will move toward next section, so select 3070 section, and you have to add image box element into the left column. So search for image box element, and this is the image box element. And next we have to add the heading element, and again you have to add the image box element on the right column. So click on the first column and select the image, and select this image, insert it. And now we have to go into the style tab, and from here we will change the width of the image. So change the width to full width, change spacing to 30, and now we will take the color and change the color of our heading by going into the content tab. And now we will copy this text and paste this content here, and the heading will be h4. Now we'll copy this designation content into the description area. Now our left column is completed. So now we will move our left column to top. So click on image element and click on advanced tab and remove margin padding, and we need to add the bottom padding 60 px. And now we give the margin -50, so our left column is moved toward. So now we move toward next section, and from now here we will copy the text, and this is our heading 6 element. So convert into heading 6. Now copy the content, paste it over here, and now come to the second element, and in this element we don't need image, so simply remove it and change the position to left, and the heading size will be h2. Now we will take the content, paste it over here, take the paragraph element and paste the content over here, add the break tag 2 times to make a perfect space. And now we will give the spacing to the right column, so click on column and now go into drones, and now we will set the padding from top 50 px and from bottom 50 px and also from the left 50 px. Okay, so now we will create our second section, and this section is our we promise section. So for this we will take a new section, and after this we will take an heading element and make it center align. And now we will take an inner section, and we need 3 sections. So now duplicate it. So in the first column we need image box element, so simply add it, and below this section we need paragraph element, So make it center align. So now select the main section and set width to 1000px. Okay. So now come into the style tab and change the background color F2F7FB. Now we will go into the advanced tab, and from here we will change the padding from top and bottom 80px. And now we will take the content. Paste it. Now come to the element of the first column. And from here we will select the image. Insert it. And now take the content from here. Copy it, paste it over here, and so we don't need the description, so we will remove it, and the heading size will be H6. Okay, and it will be center aligned, and now we will go into the column. And from here we will set the padding 40px, and now we will simply duplicate these columns and remove the extra columns that we don't need. And now we can add the content. Add the new image, insert it, take the content, paste it over here, and now we need to add this paragraph content, add this content over here, and now we will give the margin to this paragraph from left and right, so remove the padding, we only give margin. Give the margin from the right 140 and also from the left 140px to make the content center align. Now we will move to our next section, and this is our CTA section or call to action section. So to make this section we need 70-30 columns, and inside 70 column we need one more inner section. So let's start. So select 70-30 section. And now take one more inner section inside the 71 column. Okay, so now we need a heading element, so take the heading element and put it above the inner section. Okay, so now we need to create our second heading element. So take the heading element, and now we need to take our button, put button here, and change the width of this column to 75, and the second column width will be 25 automatically. Now we need to change the styling of this heading. So come into the style tab and change the color of this heading to white, and now the second element size will be H4. So change the size of this heading to heading 4. So now we will copy the content from here, and now we need a button which is already built on homepage. So come onto the homepage, edit with the Elementor, and copy that button from the homepage and then we will paste it on the about us page. So this is the button that we need. Copy it and paste it on the about us page, and we will simply remove the other button, and in this button, and we will take the text from here by pressing Ctrl Shift I, select it, click on this text, now copy this text and put this text here, Ctrl A, Ctrl V, and now we don't need icon, so remove it. So now we will make our section perfect. For this, we will click on this section and click on column gap, select no gap. So now we will fix this section. So select on the section and remove gap, no gap. And now we will come into the advanced tab, and from here we will remove the margin and also remove the padding from here, and give the margin from the top 20px, and we will give the padding 30px. Okay, and now we will change the button size to 15px. Okay, and after this we need to add a picture to main section. So click on background tab, in the style tab select the image, and from here you will see this image. Select this image, insert it, set the position to center, and repeat no repeat, and set the attachment to fix, repeat no repeat, and size will be cover. Okay, so now we need to give the background overlay. So give, select the back color and change the opacity to 0.7. okay, and now we will give the color to this section. Copy this color and paste it over here. Come into the style tab and set the background color, paste it. Okay, now change the color of the text to white. Okay, so to make the heading and button vertically aligned, so come into the section and now come into the layout tab, and from here you will select vertical align middle. Okay, and now come under the main section again and come into the layout tab and change the width 1240, and come into the advanced tab, and from here you have to give the padding from the top 80px and also 80 from the bottom. Okay, so now our section is completed. Click on update. Now we will move to our next section, and this is our pricing section. So for this we need a main section, and inside this main section we need inner section. So let's start. So first of all, take the main section and then select heading and then paragraph. Add the heading, now add paragraph, and then we need inner section. So we need three columns, so simply duplicate one column. So make the text center align. Okay, so come on to the section, and now you will take the content, and now copy the paragraph content, come to the main section. So from here you will come onto the advanced tab, and from here you have to give the margin 20px from the top, and now come onto the column section, and from here you have to come into the advanced tab and give margin 20px. Now we will give the padding 55px from the top. Now come into the style tab. Now we will change the background color, and so we need background gradient color, so choose this color and set the primary color, and secondary color will be white, and location will be 20, and the location of our secondary will be 100, and tap will be linear, and angle will be 180. Now come and select the heading element. Okay, and this heading will be heading 4 element. And now below this heading element we need another heading, and this heading will be heading 1. And now we will take the content, paste it over here, make it center align, take the other text and paste it over here, make it center align, and now come into the style tab and change the color and make the element weight to bold, and now change this heading color to white. And now we will come into the heading 1 element and come into the advanced tab, and from here we will set the margin from top 15px, and from bottom we will set 45px. And now we will add image box element below the heading 1 element. Okay, so from here we will set the heading size to h6, and now we will add the image. So select this image, then we will copy the text. So select this text, copy it and paste it into the heading section. Now text, and now copy this text, paste it over here. And now if you see that here is box shadow, so we need to apply the box shadow. So for applying this shadow effect, we will come into the style tab of our main column, and under this you will see this border section. Now change the border type. Now you, from here you have to give the border radius 15px and click on box shadow and select the blur value to 30. Okay, and from here you will change the opacity of our color, so reduce it to 0.1. And now we will come again to this element and come into the advanced tab, and from here we will change the background color to white, and then again come into the advanced tab, and from here we will set the padding 50px. Okay, so now our one section is completed. Now we will simply duplicate this section and remove the extra sections. So our pressing section has been completed. So now we will add the paragraph below this inner section. So take a paragraph element. So now add the text and make it center align. Okay, and now come into the advanced tab and change margin from the top, and now our this section is ready. So now we will move towards to the next section, and this is our cleaning expert section. So let's start creating this section. So now we need two column section, and we will take heading 2 element in the left column, and then paragraph. After this, you will select the list element, and on the right side we will use the image element. And now we will change the background color to white. So come into the style tab and change the color to white. And from here, now you have to select the column gap, no gap. And now come into the advanced tab. And from here we will set the padding from top 100. And now we will add the content to the H heading. H into the H element, copy the paragraph text, paste it over here, now we will copy the text into this element, select the checkbox or checkbox icon, this is the check icon. Now we will add the styling. Come into the style tab and come into the icon section. And now we need to change the color of the icon. So now you have to click on image element. Click over here and add the image. This is the image. This image we need. Insert it. And now select the left column and change the width of the left column to 40 and the right column width will be 60px. And now we will give margin to the right column from left 40px. And now our this section is being completed. So now we will refresh the about us page, that how it is looking. So this is our about us page and it's looking so nice. So now we will create our next residential page. So this is the page that we are going to create. And from here we will open our residential page. So click on edit. Okay. And now we need to click on edit with Elementor. And now you have to come on the gear icon. Set the page layout to full width. And click on update. So let's start creating our page header. So this is our first section. Leave your desk to us. Okay. So now we will create this section. So as you know that we have already created this section. So we will copy this section from the about us page. So copy this section from here and paste it here. Now we need to create our next section. So there are four columns, so we need a four column section. Click on this. Okay, so now we will add image box element. So search for image box element, so add it into the column. Now click on column and come into the styling tab, and from here we will change the color to white. Okay, so now you can see the background color. So now come into the advanced tab, and from here we will give the margin 10px and padding will be 20px. And now come into the style tab, and from here you can give the border radius to 12px. Click on box shadow and change the opacity to 0.1. Okay. So it is fine now. So now click on the element and select the image for this element. And this is the image that we need. Insert it. And now we need a text, living room, paste it over here. And now we need the text of the paragraph or the description area. copy this over here and paste it. Now we can simply duplicate the column 3 times and remove the extra columns that we don't need. So as you can see that the heading size is bigger, so we need to change this heading size. So what we will do, select this element and change the heading 3 to heading 5 and come into the style tab, and from here we will change the color. Select the color and paste it over here. So now our color of the heading has been changed. So now copy the styling and paste it on the other elements. So as you can see that we are pasting the styling and color is changing but not the heading size, so we have to do it manually. So select it from here, heading 5 and heading 5. So now we need to move this section to top. So select the main section, come into the advanced tab, so give the margin -60, okay, and padding bottom will be 50px. Okay, so now our one section has been completed. So now we will move towards the next section, which is all you need section. So now select a section and add image box element inside it. Okay, and after this you have to add inner section element. So now we need 4 columns, so simply duplicate it 2 times. Okay, so the basic structure is ready, so we don't need the image, so simply remove it. So click on the main section and change the width of your section to 980px, and select column no gap. Come into the advanced tab and from here and give the padding top 40px and padding bottom 100px, and come into the styling tab and change the background color. Select this code, paste the color over here. After this copy the text and paste it over here, and now copy the paragraph text and this is our heading 2. So change heading 3 to heading 2. Okay, so now copy the paragraph text, paste it over here. Now come to the inner section and come into the advanced tab and give margin and give padding top 30px. And now we need to add the elements of icon list in all columns, so drag and drop it over here. Remove extra tabs, so we don't need the icons. So simply we need text, copy it from here, paste it over here. So duplicate it. So now come into the style tab and give the spacing 10px. So our section is ready, so simply duplicate it 3 times and remove the extra sections. So our this section is ready, and now we need to create our CTA section which we have created in our home page. So what we will do, we will open our home page, click on edit with Elementor. Now copy this section and paste it over here, and this is our CTA section. Now we need to create our gallery section. So for this we need a new section. And give width 1100px to this section. And now we need to give the padding 80 from top and 80 from bottom. So now we need to add image gallery. Select this gallery element. So select the images, this and this. Now insert all these images into the gallery. Insert gallery. Okay, select the columns. Okay, now change the image size to full, and that's it. It's looking awesome. Okay, so now click on update button, and now we will reload our residential page. So this is our residential page, and it is looking so awesome. And now we will create our commercial page, which is approximately same as our residential page. So this is our commercial page, only this section is different. So what we will do, so come into our residential page and save as template this page, and this is our residential page template. Save it, and now we will go into the page of commercial. Click on edit, click on edit with Elementor, and click on the folder icon. Open this My Template tab and insert the template. Click on yes. And now the complete page is loaded. Okay, so now we just have to change the text if you want. So click on update button, and now we know that we only need to create this section, and this is a carousel section. Take heading element, make it center align, copy the text and add the text here. And now what we have to do, we have to take the element of carousel. Now we will come into the advanced tab, and then we will give the margin from top 80px. Now we will add the carousel section, drag it below the heading element, and now we will select the images, this one, this, create a new gallery and insert gallery. Okay, so make the image size full. Okay, and the slide to show 4 at a time. We want to see 4 images at a time, so we need only arrows. Okay, arrows is coming, but the color is very light. We will change the color. So now come into the style section to change the color of the arrows, and from here we can change the color of the arrows. Okay, this is our code. Copy the code and paste the code over here, and now our arrows are coming. And now we can also add the bullets. For this, click arrows and dots. Okay, so now what we will do, the position will be outside and the color will be pink. Now come into the advanced tab and give margin from the top 20px. And now click on update button. And now click on commercial page so that you can see that your commercial page is also has been ready. So now our last page has been left, and that is contact us page. So come onto the contact us page, click here edit, click on edit with Elementor. Okay, now our contact us page is open. Now change the page layout to full width, click on update. So now that you can see, the sidebar will remove automatically. So now what we will do, that copy the header from the about us page and add it into the contact us page, and our page header has been ready. Okay, select the content and paste it over here. So now we will create our next section. So click on plus icon and select two column section, and now we will change the width of this section to 1000px and column gap will be no gap. Now come on the left column and width will be 60px and the right column width will be 40px automatically. So now we need heading, and that heading will be heading 2. Now we need the text, put the text below the heading, and this is the form which is coming from the shortcode. So here we will add the shortcode element. Okay, so we will create this form using WP form. Now we need to create this section, and this is the icon box element. So search for icon box, add the icon box element over here, and now we need to design this icon box. Now we can see that our icon box is upward. So what we will do, we will go into the advanced tab and give the margin minus 50. So now our section has been moved upward. So now as you can see that our background is not coming perfectly because we had it on the wrong place. So what we will do, we give that color to the element, not to the column. Okay, so remove from the column and add this color into the element. So here we will give this background white color. So now it is coming perfectly, and here we will give the border radius 12px and give the box shadow and change the opacity to 0.1. okay, and this looking perfect. So now our next step is to give padding to the icon box. So select the element of icon box and come into the advanced tab, and from here we will give the padding 30px. And now come into the styling tab, and from here we will give the spacing 10. Okay, and the size will be 40, the icon size will be 40. And now we will give the color to our icon and the title also, and now it's looking fine. Now we will duplicate our section. We need to remove the margin minus 2, positive 20. Okay, so now duplicate this section again. Okay, so now we will add the content into our element. So first of all, we need to add the icon, and that is clock icon. So search for clock, is the clock, insert it, and now we need to add the Visa card icon into the second element. Okay, and in the third one we need to add the comment icon. Search for comment icon, and this is the comment icon, insert it. Okay, now click on update. Now what we will do to create a form, so for this we will go into the dashboard, and from here we click on plugin menu. And from here we will search for WP form plugin. And this is our WP form plugin. Click on install. Now click on activate. And now reload the page. And now you can see this plugin on the left section. Now click on all forms so that we can see that we have a form or not. So we don't have any form. We have to create from scratch. Click on add new. And now you can see that we need name, email, contact number fields. So click on create a blank form. So the first field will be name. Okay, this is the name field. So select the name field. Now click on this field. And from here, you can see that we have three columns. So now we need to change into one column. So format will be simple. So now it is coming in the one column. And now we are only seeing the name. So now if you click on advanced option, so now I also want to change the field size to full width. For this you have to select large. Okay, and now I don't want this label, so what I will check this box, hide label, but I want to show this name into placeholder, so I will type it name. So now user can know that what value he need to fill in this form. Okay, so now we need to create a second field, and now I need to add email field. So the steps will be similar. And now I need to add the fourth field, and that will be a radio button field. So how I can add this field? So click on add field, and from here we will search for radio button field, and it will be multiple choice. So simply click on this. So now here we need only two radio buttons. Okay, so copy the text and paste it over here. And now we need second option, commercial cleaning, and we will remove the third one because we don't need this. Now come into the advanced option, and I don't want to show the label, and I want to show this field into inline. Okay, so now the next field will be our address field, and the last field will be message field. So for this I will add the paragraph text field. Click on advanced option, select large or medium, it is fine. Now add the placeholder text, and it will be address. So add the label. Now click on duplicate, simply click on this. Okay, now we just need to change the placeholder text to message. Now click on save button. So if now I want to change the text of submit button, so for this I will click on setting tab. And from here, I will change the submit to send. And if I want to change the mail, so for this, we click on notification. And from here, I can change the email, that on which email the information will go whenever any user will fill the form. So I am adding this mail, is the dummy mail. So now click on save. And now I will click on all forms. As you know that we have created one form, so we need to copy the shortcode. So we will click and copy the shortcode from here and paste it into the contact us page where we have added the shortcode. And now click on apply and click on update. So now as you see that our form has been added successfully. Now reload the page and our form is showing perfectly. Okay, so now we just need to add the space. So now come again to the Elementor page. So click on the left column and now we need to add the padding to the right, and that will be 50px. And now click on the right column, and from here we need to give the padding from left 50px. Okay, so now this issue has been resolved. So now we need to create this section. Okay, so select a new section and enter a new heading element, and that will be heading 2. Make it centralized and add the text. And now we need a button, so we will copy this button from the home page. So copy this button from the home page and paste it into the contact us page. Okay, and that's it. And now copy the text by pressing Ctrl Shift I, and copy the text and paste it over here. Okay, and now what we will do to create this section, for this we will need inner section and add it below your button element. Okay, now we need image box, and from here we will remove the image because we don't need image in this section, and make the alignment to right, and the heading element will be 5h5. Now copy the content . Now copy this element and paste it on the next column. Now we change the position. So now click on advance, and now we need to give the padding to right 40px, and also you will give the padding but from the left side 40px. And now we need to add this pink line. Okay, so how we add this, you have to come into the style tab, and from here you will see this border section. Select border tab to solid. And give the width to the right 1px, and change the color to pink. So copy this color from here and paste it here. Okay, so now you can see that our border has added. Now we will give the padding from the top to this section, 100px from bottom and 50px from the top. And we will also give padding 20px from top and 20px from bottom. And now we will increase the size of the text. So text transformation will be uppercase, and the font size will be 20px. Okay, now it's looking awesome now. So click on update, and now approximately our page is been completed. So click reload, and this is our page. Okay, so now we will add color to the send button. So what we will do, press Ctrl Shift I and select your button, and select this button and click on plus icon. Now give the background color and text color to white. Okay, border radius will be 5px. And now we will change the background color to pink. Okay, and it's done. Now copy this code and paste it into the customize, and here you will see the additional CSS section where you can add this code. This is your additional CSS section. Click on it and paste the code over here and click on publish, and now reload the contact us page, and your styling has been applied successfully. So our site has been completed. Everything is perfect.